These are beautiful species of phalaleles or stink horn mushrooms from Goa University campus in Tiswadi Taluka, North Goa, in the state of Goa, India. Almost 900 millimeter of rainfall in last 25 days has resulted into the appearance of these fruit bodies of Phallus impudica species, which are a very interesting species because they produce a very sticky type of here polysaccharide glue like, which attracts flies and other insects a very long distance because it is very powerful in smell. And this is called indusium, a skirt, which is a very intricate structure, and all this is basically, it comes out of, these are the, we have harvested this from the nature. These are the 8 stages of phalaleles or stink horns. We are artificially incubating them with the hope that you can see here, they are covered into a jelly like material, and it's really sort of a interesting developmental biology. Like, just by incubation of these 8 stages, it is possible to achieve the fruit body development like this. You can see this part, which was like this. So the transformation overnight almost of these eggs to this, it occurs at such a rapid rate that it's quite intriguing, because synthesis of new proteins, new tissues, cells and everything as it is now occurring inside this must be at an extremely high rate, which is unprecedented, means in the mushroom world. And it also is subject to now huge amount of research is required in area like transcriptomics, because this type of growth from these 8 stages which we see here is not possible. Is not possible without very high, transcription, RNA transcription, protein biosynthesis. So this 8 stage in some countries in Southeast Asia is considered edible and even used as an aphrodisiac, because the mushroom is shaped like a human organ, reproductive, and there are many stories and myths and legends associated with its medicinal use. In China, these species are cultivated. So in short, mostly in Goa and Western Ghats, they are found associated with bamboo groves or areas where bamboos have been failed. We do not know, but we have to look into the mycorrhizal aspects also, because you can see here, there is a root-like structure here which we have to study further by doing slides. So these phalaleles are not really ugly nor very beautiful, but somewhere in between, because of their overall appearance, magical, beautiful from a distance, but stinking from even a shorter this one here area. But these are loved by insect world, and that is why I believe that in tropical ecosystem, these phalaleles or stink horns play a very important role, because a whole number of range of insect species depend on them. Now you can see the sticky gleba, which is full of basidiospores. Now when the insect flies, especially various types of fruit flies, sit on these beetles and fly off, they carry the sticky material in which thousands of microscopic minutest basidiospores are suspended, and then when they sit on some vegetation or litter, or these spores get dispersed, and probably they may germinate there and the mycelia may remain dormant till the next rains. And that is how the life cycle of these species, through basidiospore dispersal by using various types of these insect species, must be taking place. We don't know much about, even today, despite so much of interest in medicinal, pharmaceutical, anti-cancer, anti-tumor aspects of phalaleles and stink horns, we know very little about its ecology in natural habitat and host specificity, means whether any specific insect species are associated with these type of mushrooms. Very little is known, and also its dormancy over the year, means in In what way now this differentiation occurs from basal mycelium to the egg stage and further, that's not known. Huge amount of work is also required about the beneficial bioactive compounds from these phalloliles. So what appears as a very ugly and mysterious type of species is actually playing a interesting role, short lived, just over 2 weeks they appear and then we don't see them after end of July. So this is what we can understand from stinkhorns, and this year they have come up a week earlier than usual.